joins us now from London. Please welcome Jamie Oliver.
How you doing, guys?
We're very well. Can you now do everything? Billy and the Giant Adventure is not a cookbook. It's a kid's book and it's brilliant.
Thank you. Yeah, it was. Well, it was never really meant to be. It just happened. It was a secret little project. And really, like, one which just came about me putting my kids to bed at night. I'm dyslexic, so I was never very good at reading. So at a certain age, they sort of say, Dad, don't read. Just make something up from your head. And I just started recording them so I could remember who the characters were, because ultimately I was dreaming of the kids being asleep and me having a gin and tonic. So that's kind of where it happened. And then over the last 4 years, I've just been trying to get it into a place where it was a beautiful thing.
Well, we can tell that the book means a great deal to you. We've absolutely loved opening it up today. A lot of people, though, have these wonderful stories, but they're kind of scared of sitting down and putting pen to paper. So how did you overcome that?
For me, like, as a dyslexic kid, like, words were the enemy, right? They were the thing that sort of frightened me. I could never get my ideas down on paper. So you just find other ways. I mean, even in my cookbooks, like, I've never written them or typed them. I've always used dictaphones. And so that's what I did in this book. Then I try and just imagine it and see it, and using stickies and doing, like, almost little top trump cards of characters and building the stories. And, you know, I was ultimately trying to have a laugh. When I was telling the stories to my kids, I was trying to teach them things and values. But also, like, there was things, you know, one of my kids was also struggling at school. So, you know, that idea of the characters in the story kind of finding different ways to get over problems, I would use the story to kind of inspire her, those things. So, look, I mean, it's been great. I mean, sincerely, it was probably the most nerve-wracking launch I've ever done, because it's not my homeland, it's not cooking. But so far, so good. People seem to love it. And who doesn't love a bit of magic and a little bit of, you know, bodily function noises and all the other stuff that comes with it?
Well, there's a few Easter eggs at the back as well, a couple of recipes that you've popped in there too for everyone to enjoy. But your main character, Billy, he does go through some ups and downs, some trials, and there's a bit in there like, you know, teachers getting frustrated with him, him not being able to focus. Is that stuff that you actually drew on from your own experience?
Yeah, look, definitely. And I think, you know, the thing I've learned, you know, is, you know, everyone's got challenges. No one's the full kind of package. You know, I think there's probably 20 to 30% of kids in Aussie schools right now that struggle with neurodiversity, whether it's dyslexia and conventional learning. And I guess what I'm trying to sort of say is there's another way. There's always another way. And of course, to have friends to help you through that, you know, I mean, I couldn't do what I do without my team and friends and relationships. So I think the book is a couple of things. Like, the book is about Mother Nature and how we all have a part to play. And of course, there's magic and fun and adventure and all those sorts of things. But there's really good values in there. Like, I think, yeah, like, the kids all have to get around things a different way. And I think, and I hope that's really inspiring to kids, especially the ones that struggle at school, and also especially the parents of the ones that struggle at school, because we all worry about our kids. So, yeah, I mean, the best way to do it is always through a laugh and fantasy. I want my kids, and I want the kids to love cooking and love nature.
Well, speaking of cooking, Jamie, you're staying really busy. You're actually coming back for the upcoming season of MasterChef very soon. Yes. What have you got in store for the contestants this time around?
It is going to be epic. It is going to be so good. So I've always been a massive fan of the MasterChef Australia series. Like, they're the best crew in the world. It's the best version in the world by a long way. And it was ballistic. Like, the cooks and contestants are incredibly diverse in every way, shape and form. And you are going to have a laugh this series. I genuinely don't know who's going to win, because of course, in the time that you do the series, they genuinely, and that's not common in TV, they genuinely do develop technically, emotionally, confidence-wise. But they're brilliant. I tasted some amazing things. It was my second time on the show. But, you know, tasting 18 versions of things is actually hard work. I know no one's going to believe it was actually hard work. It's a brilliant show, and I secretly came over last year. I did two shows, and the judges made me feel really welcome, and of course, it's always a joy to be back. Back in the motherland.
Oh. Jamie, we were so chuffed that we were going to get to speak to you today. Everyone on the panel has a story about how much they love you and have grown up with your cooking and your beautiful personality. We've got Hamish was talking about your fish pie. Georgie couldn't stop talking about the naked chef. We're just, so incredibly chuffed to have you, and we hope that everything with the book goes so well.
Thank you very much. Lots of love, guys.
It's called Billy and the Giant Adventure, available now for pre-order right now.